Some people seem to be afraid of nothing in the world. They jump off cliffs, balance over ravines, and cuddle with wild animals. Others show moral courage when no one else dares, and courageously stand up for injustice. That's why, today, we're showing you 8 courageous people who kept the world on its toes. Included are extreme athletes who faced fear, and people who put themselves in mortal danger just to help other people. It's going to be very exciting, so stay tuned here at Wonderland. Oh, and write us in the comments, what was the bravest thing you ever dared to do? Let's start our list with Alain Robert, also known as the French Spider-Man. Robert, who was born in 1962 in the small French town of Dijon, is one of the best climbers in the world. However, he does not rely on safety ropes or carabiners. Robert trusts only his fingertips, and therefore climbs almost exclusively without a belay. And he prefers to do so on skyscrapers. In the course of his career, he has already climbed more than 170 skyscrapers and monuments all over the world. These include the Eiffel Tower, the Empire State Building in New York, and in 2004, the 508-meter-high Taipei 101 skyscraper, which was still considered the tallest building in the world at the time. Robert also even tried to climb the Petronas Towers in Kuala Lumpur twice, but was arrested both times at the height of the 60th floor. His climbing tours are, in fact, usually illegal, but the 59-year-old Spider-Man intends to continue as long as his physical condition allows him. In the meantime, by the way, his actions also have a political background. In 2008, for example, he climbed the New York Times building to draw attention to global warming, and last year, he climbed the Silver Tower of the Deutsche Bahn in Frankfurt to warn against excessive panic during the current pandemic. Incidentally, Robert, who has suffered several serious injuries during his career, has also climbed the world's reigning tallest building. On March 28th, 2011, he conquered the 828-meter Burj Khalifa in Dubai. This time, however, due to restrictions, he had to use rope safety. Let's continue with him here. David Blaine calls himself a magician or action artist and is known for putting himself into life-threatening situations. Especially his public stunts provide the audience with goosebumps. It is usually less about illusions or magic. Instead, Blaine wants to prove the limits to which you can push your body. He became famous in 1999 with his Buried Alive stunt. Back then, he had himself buried in a plastic box under a 3-ton water-filled tank for 7 days. During the stunt, he did not eat anything, and he fed only on 2 to 3 tablespoons of water per day. In the years that followed, Blaine then had himself locked in a block of ice for 61 hours, stood on a 27-meter-high column for 35 hours without sleep, food, or safety, or had himself locked in a water-filled plexiglass sphere for 176 hours. This also nearly resulted in disaster, as Blaine lost control of his body and passed out in the meantime. His most controversial stunt, however, took place in 2003, where he had himself hanged in a transparent cell in London. There, he spent 44 days without food and was provided only with water. When Blaine finally left the box, he could barely speak or walk. A lengthy hospital stay followed to treat severe malnutrition, as he lost 27 kilograms of body weight during the 44 days in his crate. Last year, the action artist again caused a sensation. Blaine let himself be pulled by 52 helium balloons to a height of 7,600 meters, and then landed with a parachute, which he had put on himself at an altitude of 2,200 meters. The stunt was broadcast live on YouTube and already has over 22 million views. Let's continue with a man who has been keeping the world on tenterhooks for almost 10 years and who has provided a real spy thriller. We are, of course, talking about whistleblower Edward Snowden. The US American has been working as an employee in a national security agency office in Hawaii since 2009. There, Snowden one day saw documents that proved that the NSA was watching and monitoring global internet connections. According to Snowden, not only politicians were affected, but also private individuals. In 2013, the then 29-year-old copied the evidence and called in sick to work. He flew to Hong Kong, and from there, sent the secret documents to American newspapers, which made the scandal public a short time later. Edward Snowden thus became one of the biggest whistleblowers in history and was reported by the FBI. Since then, he has been on the run, facing up to 30 years in prison or worse in the United States. He applied for political asylum in 21 different countries, but the US allegedly put pressure on the governments and the majority of the countries rejected the asylum application. Snowden now lives permanently in Russia and has even become a father here. Nevertheless, he wants to return to the US at some point, and he hopes that in time his activities will be seen in a more positive light. Another man who had to summon up an incredible amount of courage for his stunt and kept millions of people around the world in suspense is the US American Nick Wallander. The tightrope artist, who balanced on a rope for the first time at the age of 2, keeps breaking records. In 2012, for example, he crossed Niagara Falls, and a year later, as the first person ever, the gorge of the Grand Canyon unsecured on a rope. He had spent years planning the 425-meter balancing act at a dizzying height of 457 meters. He even used wind machines to generate artificial gusts. In the following years, he also balanced blindly and unsecured between the Marina Towers in Chicago or over Times Square in New York. It was only last year, however, that the artist with German roots fulfilled his greatest dream. Wallander walked a tightrope across an active volcano in Nicaragua. There, he not only had to endure unpredictable winds and heat, the poisonous vapors put such a strain on him that he could only survive the walk with a breathing mask. Let's continue with a man whose name and fate remains unknown to this day. Despite this, or perhaps because of it, he showed incredible courage and kept the world on its toes. We are talking about the Unknown Demonstrator, also called Tank Man in the media. On June 5th, 1989, the unknown man stepped completely alone onto Chang'an Avenue in Beijing and confronted a seemingly endless column of Chinese tanks. He did so to stop the column, which was on its way to suppress protests in Tiananmen Square. Only a day before, a popular uprising there had turned into a catastrophe. The unarmed man even got on the first tank and started a conversation with its driver. Civilians finally dragged the unknown demonstrator off the road, and he disappeared into the crowd. What then became of the Tank Man is still not known, but his photo went around the world, and Time magazine listed the unknown rebel as one of the 100 most influential people of the 20th century. Now, let's move on to a whole group of people who were extremely brave and whose fate kept the world on tenterhooks. We are talking about the 12 boys who, together with their coach, were trapped in a cave in Thailand in 2018 and their heroic rescuers. The cave drama took its course when the teenagers were surprised by a flash flood and retreated into a cave. Shortly thereafter, they were trapped by the masses of water and were presumed missing. It was only after 9 days that the group was discovered and a race against time began. More than 1,000 helpers, rescue workers, and divers were involved in the rescue operation, including soldiers from the Thai Navy SEALs, as well as helpers and teams items from various other countries, such as the United Kingdom, China, Australia, the United States, and Germany. Just one day later, 7 divers were then able to get to them, including a doctor who stayed with the children in the cave until they were rescued. However, the rescue operation became more and more dramatic, because the oxygen level in the cave dropped rapidly, and one diver did not survive the whole operation. In addition, most of the children could not swim, and they had to dive through narrow passages that could only be overcome without a scuba tank on their backs. Nevertheless, all the youngsters, as well as the trainer, were rescued from the flooded cave after 17 days, thanks only to their incredible courage and stamina. Let's continue with a woman who kept the entire USA on tenterhooks with her symbolic climbing action. The activist Therese Okomo climbed the Statue of Liberty in New York on July 4th, 2018, the American Independence Day. Her destination was the top of the statue, but she wasn't there to enjoy the view to celebrate the USA. Instead, she used the unusual location to protest the separation of migrant families at the US-Mexico border. Nevertheless, the action was extremely dangerous, and the police had to cordon off the entire area. Negotiations between police and the activist lasted for 2 hours, and finally, officers climbed the pedestal to arrest the protester. Therese Okomo was eventually sentenced to 5 years probation and 200 hours of community service. Last but not least, we come to our first place. On October 14th, 2012, Austrian Felix Baumgartner parachuted to Earth from a height of 39 kilometers. His jump was broadcast live on every possible channel and sponsored by Red Bull. What hardly anyone knows is that Felix Baumgartner held the record for the highest stratospheric jump of all time for just 2 years. Because, while Baumgartner was being celebrated internationally for his jump, US computer scientist Alan Eustace was quietly preparing for his own record attempt. At the time, Eustace was part of Google's top management, and his jump was part of a project to enable manned exploration of the stratosphere. On October 24th, 2014, the time had come. Eustace, who was 57 years old at the time, ascended to the top of the stratosphere above Roswell in the state of New Mexico in a helium balloon. Unlike Baumgartner, he was not in a capsule, but in a special suit hanging from a construction below the balloon. After a 2.5 hour ascent, he spent half an hour moving around in the stratosphere. Finally, he dropped to Earth from an altitude of 41 kilometers, experiencing a 5-minute freefall. At over 1,300 kilometers per hour, he thus became the second person to break the sound barrier, but he was slightly slower than Baumgartner. Eustace demonstrated incredible courage with his jump, and still holds the record today. And that's it for 8 brave people who kept the world on its toes. Like this video if you enjoyed it, and see you next time, here at Wonderland.